gonna make Butterbeer coffee today. So this is gonna be fun. So I'm gonna start with the cream just because it's a bit more complex. I use a mason jar to make it because I'm putting it on top. Now I'm making Butterbeer foam from a recipe that I've found. And I'm making it a little bit different because I have butterscotch syrup, which you can get from the Torani website. I couldn't find butterscotch sauce, or I would have bought that. It's a relatively easy recipe. I, in fact, don't follow a measurement because I'm only gonna make a little bit for right now. So, she got creamy again. We're gonna take a spoon of marshmallow cream. And we're gonna put that in there. Now I'm gonna kind of mess with the cream a little bit just because it does get hard to froth. This is difficult. Come on, marshmallow cream. This is just annoying. Never mind. Alright, I'm gonna do a little bit of butterscotch. You don't want to do too much butterscotch because you're gonna put it in the coffee as well. You just want like a little bit. While we have it out, we're gonna do the sea salt. I like to make sure I do enough that I can see a good amount. And then we're gonna do some heavy whipping cream. If I can find it in the fridge, it's gonna disappear on me. See if I can. Where's my frother? There she is. Hiding from me. You don't have to blend this with the frother, you could do it with a blender. I'm doing it with a frother because I have one. And I'm trying to get good down on the clumps of the marshmallow cream because this stuff doesn't blend well. Add a little bit more heavy whipping cream and butterscotch syrup because I just don't feel like this is a lot. You know, when you make a little cold foam, you want a little decent amount of cold foam. And there's just not that here. And I'm just not going to add more marshmallow cream because it's difficult to work with. I feel like it's pretty thick,
so I'm going to call it with that.
And we're going to put our little spoon in the sink, our cup. And we're going to take our mason jar, put it aside, and we're going to get out our cup for our coffee. So we're going to put a little bit of scotch. Like, that's a decent amount. And I don't have any but sauce, but I am going to do a little caramel just because it's fun. And then I'm going to take my little frother guy and I'm going to froth that to mix it together. I love to do this. Gotta get your syrup kind of combined so it's not just syrupy and thick, because that's usually what happens when you do syrup. Alright, so this is my iced coffee. It is not stock cold brew. I've put iced coffee in here. You could do cold brew, you could do whatever kind of coffee you want. I'm gonna put ice. Which I usually do with my hand, and I forgot that I like to stir. So it's a little dark because of the caramel. I just dropped that on the floor. But it's gonna be alright. Teensy bit of milk, just a teensy. I like my coffee brown. Literally, I said teensy and that's it. And we're gonna pour this on top. We're gonna have a beautiful foam. Oh, look at that. That is gorgeous. And that is our Butterbeer. Iced coffee. And so that's all for this part of the video. I'm gonna also do a cooking some zesty crock pot chicken, but I'm gonna save it for another video because I want to take a picture of this. Okay, so I of course had to stir it like crazy to get it mixed. I don't know about you, but I like my coffee a little sweet, and I definitely didn't add enough syrup and stuff or milk or anything. I should have added a little bit more milk. But anyway, it still looks pretty. We're gonna make our crock pot chicken. So I'm gonna get out the ingredients and we're gonna have some fun. Alright. I'm gonna tell you as I take it out. Italian seasoning. Chicken. I need a barbecue sauce. I saw some in here. I saw it. Alright. Barbecue sauce. I need Worcestershire. Worcestershire. Where's the Worcestershire? That one almost empty. We're gonna use this one. And then brown sugar. So I'm gonna get measurements out. I need a tablespoon, ¼ a cup, and 3/4 a cup. Alright. First thing I'm gonna do is shake this up. Because we don't want no watery Italian seasoning in our stuff. Okay. I'm not gonna plug it in or turn it on until I am done putting the ingredients in here. You're asking why this is in a Walmart bag. Because it was opened yesterday. These are chicken tenderloins. The recipe calls for chicken breast, but I think this will be fine because this is already defrosted and I don't have to deal with it anymore. So we're just gonna pop these guys in here. But actually, nope. We wanna spray it first. I don't know why I didn't to do this the other day, but I'm gonna do it today. Oh, probably won't need to, but I'd rather be safer than sorry. So now we put them in. And we're just gonna cover the bottom with chicken. Now I cooked some of this chicken yesterday, so there's not a ton. But I don't need there to be a ton. Because I'm not feeding that many people. But this is still like a lot of chicken. So we're just gonna scoochie. Alright, so it pretty much covers the whole bottom. I'm gonna throw this away and then I'm actually gonna wash my hands. Alright, so we're gonna start with our 3/4 cup of Italian seasoning. Dressing, not seasoning. Huh, those are two different things, buddy. I'm gonna use a liquid measuring cup because I just feel wrong now. Also, I feel like it'll be easier. I'm trying to measure out some of the stuff so I just can dump it in. I need 1/4 cup of this. I guess I'm good. So it says one bottle of barbecue sauce, but I'm gonna go read on the website of how many ounces that said, because I don't have a whole bottle, but I don't want to use all of this, so we're gonna find out how much we're supposed to use. It says a 12 ounce, and this is a 40 ounce bottle, so yeah, we don't need the whole bottle, so we're gonna figure out how to measure that. Oh, look! This one has the measurements for me. That's about enough, if not more. So it says barbecue sauce. We're just pouring that in over here. I'm gonna get a spoon in a second. I just realized I should get all your barbecue sauce out. That's what he's going to be back in there. Alright. I'm leaving out my spoon in case I need them. And we're going to do our Italian. Okay, putting it to the Italian. Sprinkle and brown sugar. Alright, I'm going to put the top on and plug it in, and it says to do it for 4 to 6 hours, I believe. Hold on, recipe scroll to the top. Cook on low for 6 to 8 hours, so I'm gonna do 8, and I'm just not gonna touch it. And I have a bunch of dishes to do. This vlog is already at a really low point from all of this fun jazz. So I'm gonna... Hello, we're back. I'm making Butterbeer ice cream, and right now I'm doing the different things. So I have butterscotch sauce over here, and I still haven't added rum extract to. I'm letting it cool before I can do that. And I'm making my base right here. I'm trying to get them both to be in the fridge at the same time, so that way I can just have them and take them out when I need to start churning. Because I want to get this ice cream made ASAP. So I think this is pretty combined. I'm using this container that has a lid. It says to cover with foil, but I think this will be fine. So this is my like heavy cream and half and half, because I kind of ran out of heavy cream.
And now I'm going to rinse this out.
I need a half a cup of cream soda. I'm glad I used this size bowl and not a bigger one. I didn't need a bigger one. So this is my ice cream base. I'm mixing in the butterscotch sauce in like the ice cream later. So this is gonna be interesting. So my best tips for making this ice cream specifically, not necessarily just any ice cream. I chose one that I can churn because I wanted to bake like a soft serve kind of style, maybe, like they do at the parks. So that's ready to go in the fridge. So now we're gonna attend to this. So this is rum extract, and I need a fourth of a teaspoon. Oh man, I gotta open it. I'm gonna film me making the whole stuff thing, but I felt like this would be a little bit shorter. Okay. That might be a little bit more than I need, but I love the fact that we're using rum extract to make it have a little bit of room up in there. That's nice. Okay, this is definitely cooler. So this is brown sugar, water, butter, cider vinegar, salt, heavy cream, and rum extract. So just so you know, I will link the recipe that I used to make this stuff below. I promise. So this is the container I'm storing it in. What's better than a mason jar? And I have about dirtied all the dishes in the house. I'm gonna put both of these in the fridge. Try to. I don't know if there's a place for this big one. And then we're gonna leave them in there for a couple hours. So we're gonna make a little bit of room here. Because I am gonna be taking them out later on, obviously. So I don't care about this space for a long period of time. I just care about it for right now. So that's in the fridge. I'm gonna set a timer for two hours on my phone. We'll come back and check on it, and then we'll get to churning and stuff later. Hey guys, it's a little later. I combined the butterscotch sauce with the base and I have it in the ice cream maker now churning. It has like 8 minutes and 25 seconds left and I'm really excited to try it. I hope it's going to be like the soft serve like I want so I can go ahead and eat some. But if not, I'll just put it in the freezer and I'll just have to eat it frozen. It's fine. My crock pot over here is not one warm because she cooked in less than 6 hours. Maybe in six. Maybe I should have just done it on six. I didn't want to do it on high. I wanted to do it on low. And our options are either high, 4 to 6, or low, 8 to 10. So, like, I don't, like, we don't have the option to do high and then so many hours. So, like, I don't know. But I don't know if you can even hear me because the ice cream thing's really loud. But anyway, that's the update on the ice cream. We're going to try it. I didn't save any butterscotch sauce for on top, but it's okay. I want it to be Butterbeer flavor. I don't care about the extras. Okay, I churned it for another 5 minutes up to the 15, and it's not really soft servey. I feel like it's still very liquidy, so I'm just putting it in the freezer. And hopefully in a couple hours, it will be at the consistency that I want. And I can eat it for dessert. Because it tastes really good. And I thought it would be, the way I looked at it. Like, it looked like it, and I was like, But, like, I don't know. I feel like it's not thick enough. Maybe I just need a soft serve machine. But, I don't know. I like my ice cream a little thick. Like, thick enough to, like, be able to eat it and, like, it not just, like, melt off the spoon. Because it's so liquidy. So, I put it in the freezer, which I always have to make room for. So, I just did that off camera. Pick up the little ice cream churner. Top thingy McJig over here. And probably see you guys when I shred this chicken later. So this is just a cooking video. This isn't even a vlog. Sorry. I think it's fun.